it does appear that many of the prophecies, if you want to call it that, or, you know, predictions, were that as the globe warmed, that you would have more intense events on a wider scale than we previously had, and that does in fact seem to be happening. You know, there's still debate as to whether, you know, how much can we actually, you know, how much is within our control, and, you know, what actions, are there actions that we could take today that would have an immediate effect tomorrow? In many cases, probably not. You know, are we geared enough to sort of think long term, you know, 20, 50, 100 years hence? That's harder to do sometimes than to look at the, you know, at the immediate emergency in front of us. And again, you know, I've tried to indicate in here, I don't by any means discount, you know, the, what do they call it, the Cajun Navy, Salvation Army. I mean, there are groups. Red Cross, if I remember correctly, I think I have the document here, it was sort of the first example that we have of the government actually commissioning a private group to sort of coordinate with them in public relief efforts. And, you know, these groups can be important. And, you know, I'm sure there are people probably listening who are, you know, first responders, you know, our local fire and police and, you know, many disaster services are there, and they do perform a vital function.